Greetings, saints, and grace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Billy D. Welcome to today's Moments in Ministry. Water is essential to life and to nearly all functions of the human body. Water helps to keep tissues in the eyes, nose, and mouth moist. It helps protect body organs and lubricate joints. Water dissolves the minerals and nutrients in food, making them accessible to the body. And water also helps carry those nutrients throughout the body. Recent studies have shown that drinking 5 or more glasses of water per day can even reduce the risk of heart attack by around 50% over drinking 2 fewer glasses of water. It is no secret that people, animals, and plants must have water to live. In Ezekiel's vision, a man with the appearance of bronze showed him a stream of water flowing from the temple that is even more necessary to life than the water from the faucet. When the stream, which quickly became a river, reached the ocean, the waters of the sea were healed. Along the banks of the river grew trees that never withered and bore new fruit every month. Most amazingly, the man told Ezekiel that everything will live wherever the river goes. In Ezekiel 47:9, Jesus wants his people to be sustained by water from the wells of salvation, Isaiah 12:3. Once we experience the water of salvation, a new miracle occurs. Jesus said, "He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water," John 7:38. Ezekiel's stream, at first only ankle deep, kept getting wider and deeper until it was a river that could not be crossed. Ezekiel 47:5. Jesus wants his gospel message to be spread the same way from person to person until the whole world has access to his living water. Here's a slice of today's bread of heaven from Psalms 36:7-9. "How excellent is thy loving kindness, O Lord! Therefore the children of men put their hearts under the shadow of thy wings. They shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of thy house, and thou shalt make them drink of the river of thy pleasures. For with thee is the fountain of life. In thy light shall we see light." Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So until we come this way again, may God bless you and keep you is my prayer.